Good afternoon, everyone. This is Sayed Fasiuddin from ISL Engineering College from EC department. Today I'm going to explain you about the pulse and linear integrated circuits, and that will be having voltage controlled oscillator, in short we call it as VCO, which we are using in phase lock loop. So what is actually the meaning of voltage controlled oscillator and why we are using this in phase lock loop? With its pin description, with its block diagram, this two part, today we are going to cover these two things. So let us take a previous class summary. In the previous class we have discussed about phase lock loop. It consists of three blocks in it. One of the block we are discussing today is voltage control oscillator. So we know it, voltage control oscillator is an IC which is given by the signets NE and SE with 566 IC number. So what is this IC consist of? How many pins IC it is there? It consists of 8 pin IC, in which it has pin number 1, which is a ground one, and pin number 2, which is no change. We are not using any kind of change in it. And then pin number 3, it is called it as square wave output. Pin number 4, it is used for triangular wave output. And pin number 5, it's for modulation input. So since we know it, this kind of oscillations and the kind of voltage control oscillators are used in communication systems as well. That's the reason the concept of modulation come into picture. So we'll be having the modulation input over here. The next we had pin number 6, it's using the resistor R1 and we're using capacitor C1. These two are used for active low pass filtering. So these two combination we're using in our PLL. Then it is nothing but supply V+. This is the IC, outlook of the IC, pin in description. The detail about that one is over here. As you can see in this, we'll be having three blocks in it. One is the current source, another one is Schmitt trigger, next we had buffer amplifier. So what is the pin number 6? As in this we have seen, the pin number 6 is consist of resistor R1 and the pin number 7 is capacitor C1. So we had 6 pin number is for resistor R1, then we had pin number 7 is for capacitor C1. These two we are going to connect. The next thing is that we are giving the modulation input from the pin number 5. So that the pin number 5 is modulation inputs which we are giving to pin number 5. Then we had a supply over there, V+, that is for the pin number 8. Then we had Schmitt trigger, then we had buffer amplifier. From there we are getting the a clock signal, which we are nothing but square wave output. Similarly, how it is going to work, the working of this oscillator, we are going to see. Now let us see the working of this voltage control oscillator. So we, by referring the circuit above, we can say that the capacitor C1 and the C1, how the C1 is going to be charged or discharged depends upon the constant current source or sink. The amount of current, whatever the current we are passing, that can be controlled by changing the voltage VC. So by changing this voltage VC, this current C1 is going to be monitored. And whenever we apply the modulating input to the pin number 5, when is the pin number 5 is there, the same change should be there for the resistor R1, which we are connecting externally, this resistor. So next thing is that if the modulating voltage at pin number 5 is increasing, so what is the modulating voltage at this voltage? If it is increasing, the voltage also at pin number 6 must also increase. The whatever the voltage is there, that if it is increasing, that pin number 6 voltage also increasing, resulting the less voltage across the R1. So the R1 should be at less voltage. Thus we can say that the voltage across C1, whatever the voltage across C1 is there, is applied to the inverting input terminal of Schmitt trigger. So here we are saying it is a inverting, that is nothing but minus. So we had two terminals, one is inverting, another is non-inverting. So we are putting this to inverting terminal of Schmitt trigger. We are by using the buffer amplifier. From this amplifier we are going to get. And next thing is that the output voltage swings of this Schmitt trigger is designed as, suppose the output voltage for this one is, we are seeing that VCC, and the minimum they should have is 0.5 VCC. When the voltage on the capacitor C1, whatever the voltage is there at C1, is exceed from 0.5 VCC, whatever the supply we are giving, if this is increasing 0.5 VCC, so then what is going to happen? If the output at the Schmitt trigger is become low. When the capacitor is discharged, then that means 1/4 of VCC, that is 0, whatever the voltage we are getting from this one is 1 by 4 is nothing but 0.25 VCC, the Schmitt trigger voltage become high. So the square wave output of Schmitt trigger is inverted to the buffer amplifier. From this buffer amplifier, the square wave is going to be inverted because we are giving to the inverting amplifier. So this is the pin number 3. So as we have seen over here, the pin number 3 is what? Square wave output, and pin number 4 is what? Triangular wave output. So pin number 3 is square wave and pin number 4 is what? Triangular output. So these two outputs we are getting as per our pin description of IC 5666, that is nothing but voltage control oscillator. Now the next criteria is about the frequency of voltage control oscillator. What is the frequency of voltage control oscillator and how it is going to be varied? So that depends upon two types of voltage we had. Here we had plus VCC, or we say V plus, that is a voltage across input supply. Then we had the voltage across this modulating input is VC. So if you want to get the frequency, F0 is equal to 2 times of voltage across, difference of V plus and VC. Both you have to take a difference of it, divided by what are the external resistor C1 and R1. These two into the supply voltage V. Because based upon these all parameters, your frequency F0 will depends. So what we can say for this, we can say that the output frequency of VCO can be changed either by changing the R1 or by changing the C1 or by changing the voltage supply of the modulating input VC. By changing these all three parameters, your voltage is going to be monitored. So hence, this is the complete description of voltage control oscillator with its pin description and with its the internal structure of VCO. So where V plus, we can say it as VCC. So since I am indicating over here, the supply voltage is V plus. Now come back to our working of PLL. That is, we already discussed about this working. We left with how the supply is going to be obtained. So when we are giving reference voltage, it is passing to the phase detector, then we are going to the voltage control oscillator, and we will be having the loop active filter. So then we are going to get the output over this terminal. So now internally, how this phase lock loop is going to be monitored, that part we are going to see. So as you can see over here, we'll be having the pin configuration of PLL IC 565. So it consists of how many pins? It consists of 14 pin IC. So in that, it is also given by Signetix by NE or slash SE 565. This is IC number. Then the pin description, so whatever the pin is there, it is called DIP, that is nothing but dual in package pins. So what is the first supply? It is minus VC, and then we had the supply plus V. So this minus V and plus V is a supply and ground. Then pin number 2 and 3 we are giving the input. Then pin number 4 and 5 is for voltage control oscillator output. Just now we have discussed about voltage control oscillator internal part, that continuation, how this is going to be interlinked with PLL. So at the pin number 4 we are connecting the VCO, that is nothing but voltage control oscillator. The next we had pin number 5 is used for phase comparator. So as we are having phase detector over here, so that also be done at the pin number 5. Then we had pin number 6 is for reference output, and the 7 is for demodulated output. Since in the VCO we'll be having the modulated input, now we want to get the demodulation signal. These two part of that is used in the communication for giving the modulation for our given message signal with over the carrier signal. We are modulating the signal and we are going to get the output of the signal. So these are the first pin number 1 to 7. So likewise, we had pin number 8 to 14. So pin number 8 is for external resistor for VCO. So since we are connecting external resistor also, I'll explain you in the complete detail how it is going to be there. Like that, pin number 9 is for external capacitor for VCO, that is voltage control oscillator. Like that, pin number 10, already I have said it is for supply. Then 11 is no change, 12, 13, 14. So these pins are reserved. So we are not using in our circuitry part. So this how, this IC, how it is internally linked with our complete structure of the diagram. So as we can see in this, as I already have said, this is 2 and 3 is used for input. So 2 and 3 is giving as an input. It is passing to our phase detector. So then phase detector, what it does from the pin number 5, what is there? VCO input is there. So that VCO input is coming from pin number 5. Like that, pin number 4 is for VCO output. So since we are giving input over there, the output need to be obtained for the voltage control oscillator. Next, 7. Pin number 7, where we had, this is a pin number 7, it is going to get connect for demodulated output. So whatever the output we are getting, the 7 is giving the after amplifier demodulated output we are going to get. So like that, pin number 8 is for external resistor for VCO. So what is external resistor? This is external resistor which is internally connected to our VCO. So from this supply, we had a supply, we are connecting to the voltage control oscillator that is passing at the pin number 7. So we connected resistor and we want what? Actually capacitor. Why we want these two parameters? Because we want to design active low pass filter. How the low pass filter will be there? It consists of your resistor and capacitor. So these two will be working as low pass filtering. Because in our phase log loop, it consists of phase detector, active low pass filter, and the feedback is there, and we had voltage control oscillator. So we want to design the active low pass filtering by connecting external capacitor and external resistor, both the parameter. So like that, pin number is 10 is done, 11 is for supply. So what is the pin number 10 is given? Whatever the given is supply is there, 11 is 12, 13, 14, all are no change. So we are not connecting anything. This is the IC, exactly same as any SE. Only this is description, this is the internal connection, how it is going to be get. So now after that, what is going to be got, or what actually we are going to learn? We are going to learn about its description, how the description is going to be there. So as we can see in PLL, there will be different versions are there. So like this, if you see PLL block diagram, the Signetic explain about any 560 series, which is having different series, 560, 561, 562, 564, 5, so on. But mostly, how, why they have these many number of series? That depends upon their operating frequency, that depends upon their voltage supply, that depends upon whatever the input supply and volt output supply we are going to get, and input supply what we are going to give. So mostly we are going to use the 565, as we are using over here is 565. What are the specification for 565 is there, that we are going to see. So 565 specifications are what? It is having operating frequency of range from 0.001, from these very precise to the 5 kilohertz of frequency they are able to operate. Next thing is what? Operating voltage range, how much voltage they can able to operate it. It's from plus or minus 6 to plus or minus 12 volts. Then input level for tracking, whatever the tracking they want to do it, RMS 10 millivolts to the 3 volts peak to peak. From the maximum they can take this much, and minimum is 10 millivolts RMS. So this is what actually input leveling for tracking. Like that, input impedance, whatever the input impedance they can take typically is 10 kilo ohm. What is the output sink current, minimum and the maximum what they are getting, the typical value is what, 1 milliampere. Like that, output source current, this is for sinking, this is for source. So this is what, 10 milliampere. So we want to get the center frequency of phase log loop is determined by taking the free running frequency of VCO, which is given by F out is equals to 1.2 in of 4 R1C1 hertz. This is the frequency our phase log loop is going to be operated for free running frequency. So this is about the phase log loop, this is about voltage control oscillator, its ping diagram, its block diagram, internal connection, and its circuitry description with the specifications. So this is about the PLL. Thank you for listening to my video, and try to learn more concept on PLL, as it's a important question every time they are going to ask in Usmania University paper explaining about phase log loop. So, and as per our communication, the application part already we have said that it is widely useful in communication of your systems and the modulation systems in the radars and satellite communications. This PLL concept is widely used. So as per our communication, those who want to go for the research kind of thing in the communication, it will be helpful for those students to understand in depth of the phase log loop. Okay then, thank you, Allah Hafiz. Have a nice day, stay at home, don't go outside unnecessary, protect yourself, protect your family and your surroundings and the neighbors. Try to motivate them to stay at home. Allah Hafiz, fi amanillah.